Today's topic is on a condition called keratosis obtuvans. First, let us see the structure of the ear. If you see this picture, in this, only in the external auditory canal or external canal, you can find a normal skin-lined cavity. The replacement of the skin in the ear and in the body is totally different. Actually, in the body, the skin is replaced by replacement from below upwards. But in the ear, it is not from below upwards, it is from inside out. The old new skin forms from inside and pushes all the old skin outside. That's how it works in the ear. In this condition called keratosis obtuvans, which means keratin means skin, obtuvans means obstruction. So the skin is getting obstructed. What happens is the migration of the ear canal skin is not normal. So at what particular point the migration is impaired, so it gets stuck there, it lays in layers and obstructs the canal. That's what happens. And in fact, it can even destroy the nearby bones too, ear canal bones too. It makes it thin first and it destroys it next. So at this stage, if you ask me, how can you define keratosis obtuvans? It is defined as excessive desquamation of external canal keratin, which is layered in layers, which blocks the ear canal due to abnormal skin migration of the ear. And it is seen in a younger age group between the age of 20 to 40, and the cause is not known. Let us see the common presentations. The common presentations are itching, severe ear pain, hearing loss, and sometimes less commonly ear discharge. On examination, it looks exactly like a ear wax with a whitish color tinge. Now, do we need any investigation? Usually no. Sometimes in a very less number of percentage, you may need to rule out other conditions. So you may need CT scan of the ear. So coming to the treatment part, the doctor will try to prescribe you ear drops, which is ear softening agents, which you need to apply three drops three times daily for a few days, say about 3 or 5 days. And during review, we'll try to remove the keratin plug in the OPD itself. If by any chance it is getting difficult to remove, it's very painful too, we have to remove under anesthesia. In that case, we need a concern from you, followed by clearance from the physician if you have any coexisting other problems like diabetes and hypertension or bronchial asthma or anything. You have to see whether you are fit for it. With that fitness, you need to see the anesthetist to get anesthesia clearance and admission for a day. And the surgery is going to be removal of the keratin plug in the ear. And the duration of surgery is going to be less than one hour, say about 30 minutes to 45 minutes. And the post-operative period, you'll get a course of antibiotic and analgesic. Now, the most important point is, if this keratin plug forms again, we have to take you to operation theater again for removal. So it is better that you keep a regular touch with the doctor so that you review with him every 3 months and 6 months, and whatever keratin plug is formed in the ear, you take it off before it obstructs the ear canal. That is the message in this video. Thank you so much. Please do subscribe and don't forget to press on the like button. Thank you so much.